Aircraft lighting plays a critical role in aviation safety and operation. Each type serves a unique function during flight. In today's video, we're going to explain aircraft lighting, its different types, their importance, and the regulations pilots must follow. Before we get started, make sure you like this video and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy for more insightful aviation information and tips. Let's get started. Aircraft lighting has come a long way since the Wright brothers, whose flyer had none. Early planes relied on minimal cockpit lighting, but in 1925, the PW-8 became the first aircraft with landing lights, replacing the risky wingtip and parachute flares used for night flying. As aviation advanced, so did lighting systems, enhancing safety during takeoff, landing, and night operations. Today, LED technology dominates, offering brighter, more efficient, and longer-lasting lighting that benefits both commercial and military aviation, proving that even small innovations can make a big impact in the sky. There are two main types of aircraft lighting, interior and exterior. Interior lighting improves visibility inside the cabin and cockpit, while exterior lighting enhances safety by making the aircraft visible in both the sky and on the ground. Let's break down exterior lights a bit more.
My name's Josh Rawlins. I'm the Chief Operating Officer for Epic Flight Academy. I started here 23 years ago as an aircraft maintenance apprentice and got my AMP and worked my way up to the company. I'm gonna start with taking you on a tour of what each individual light is that you see on the aircraft, on the exterior of the aircraft. This is a 2023 Cessna 172. It's one of our flight school airplanes. So we'll start here. The center section is your taxi light, and the two on the outside are your landing light. If you look, the center section, the outside is a little bit rougher. So think about this like your low beams and your high beams in your car. The taxi in the center is like your low beams. The landing lights are obviously for landing. They're a lot brighter. So you're gonna have a lot more light to be able to see while you're landing, aiming down at the runway when the landing lights are on. And those are on both wings. Moving on from that, this is the right-hand nav light, which is green. You have the exact same thing over on the left-hand side, except it's red. Red over on the left, green on the right. That is pretty standard in all industries, you know, not just aviation, but in maintenance. And it helps another pilot or another boat understand which direction the aircraft is traveling by which color lights you see and what side they're on. Next to that, you have your strobe light. They flash really bright. They just help the aircraft be seen in the air from further distances. You can see that bright flashing strobe light. On the tail section, we have our nav light back here, which is a white nav light. It's always a white nav light on the tail. And on the top, you have your red flashing beacon. All the lights on this aircraft are now LED. They used to be basically incandescent bulbs on all the older aircraft. Obviously the LEDs last a lot longer. They're much more reliable. They're much brighter. They draw less current. One of the other things that comes with them though is like an incandescent light. If you had less current due to a ground issue or something like that, the light may still come on very dim, where LED lights, if there's a voltage or a current issue, will just shut off completely. So you don't really have that kind of dim phase. They're either on or they're off.
Obstruction lights ensure aircraft and obstacles stay visible in the sky. Mounted on wingtips or tails, they help other pilots spot an aircraft in flight. When placed on towers, buildings, or other structures, they are known as aircraft warning lights, preventing potential collisions. Inside the cabin, emergency lighting is a lifesaver, literally. These lights automatically activate during emergencies, illuminating exits, aisles, and escape routes to guide passengers to safety. The FAA and ICAO enforce strict lighting regulations to enhance safety in aviation. Aircraft lighting requirements vary based on the situation. For example, navigation lights must be on from sunset to sunrise. Beacon lights must remain on whenever the engine is running. strobe lights should be used during takeoff, flight, and landing. However, they can be turned off in clouds or fog to prevent blinding the pilot. Landing lights are recommended below 10,000 feet and mandatory at controlled airports. Aircraft lighting requirements vary based on type and operation. Commercial aircraft must comply with strict FAA and ICAO regulations, especially for passenger flights. Military aircraft often use infrared or covert lighting for tactical missions. Private jets and modern civil aircraft rely on advanced LEDs for better visibility with low power consumption. Meanwhile, ultralights and light sport aircraft are typically limited to daytime flying, though some may operate in twilight if equipped with anti-collision lights. Aircraft lights also serve as communication tools. They allow pilots to send signals to other aircraft and ground personnel. Some commonly used signals include flashing taxi lights. These indicate the aircraft is moving on the ground. Alternating red and white runway lights. These are to warn pilots of runway ends or obstructions. Flashing wing lights. Aircraft use these during nighttime maneuvers to improve visibility. Pilot training involves extensive instruction on the proper use of aircraft lights. When and how to use different lights during flight phases, the importance of compliance with FAA and ICAO laws, and how to interpret signals and react accordingly in low visibility conditions. Understanding aircraft lighting diagrams is essential for pilots, mechanics, and engineers. At Epic Flight Academy, we incorporate this into both pilot and aircraft mechanic training. These diagrams show the components and electrical circuits of lighting systems, which allow AMTs to troubleshoot issues. Decoded schematics help in identifying specific light placements and operation modes. Aircraft mechanics perform thorough inspections of interior and exterior lighting systems. This ensures compliance with FAA and ICAO regulations while maintaining flight safety. During an inspection, they focus on these key areas. Operational functionality. AMP mechanics are responsible for checking that all lights, including navigation, anti-collision, landing, and strobe lights, are functioning properly. This involves verifying proper illumination, correct flashing sequences for strobe and beacon lights, and that the lights activate according to operational phases, such as landing lights turning on before takeoff. Bulb and LED condition. Mechanics inspect the LEDs or bulbs for burned out or broken lights, dimming or discoloration, which can indicate aging components, and proper color output to ensure red and green navigation lights are positioned correctly on the wingtips. Electrical and wiring integrity. The electrical system must be robust. Therefore, mechanics examine wiring for fraying, loose connections or corrosion, proper voltage supply and grounding, and check the circuit breakers and switches for correct operation. Lens and housing condition. Epic AMPs prioritize safety, inspecting housings and lenses for cracks, dirt, and moisture that can reduce visibility. They also check for secure attachment to prevent detachment during flight and ensure that seals and gaskets are protected against water intrusion. Compliance with regulations. Ensuring that lighting meets FAA, ICAO, and military specifications is the minimum requirement for aircraft mechanics. At Epic, our mechanics go above and beyond to exceed these standards, prioritizing safety by ensuring proper intensity and colors for different aircraft types, compliance with safety laws for obstruction and emergency lights, and accurate positioning based on aircraft design and diagram specifications. Inspection during different conditions. Mechanics check lights in outdoor settings under various conditions, including night operations, to determine effectiveness. They follow a detailed inspection checklist to ensure that lighting systems function reliably. Mechanics do their part to support pilots and passengers and ensure overall flight safety. These safety measures are crucial, and Eastern Airlines Flight 401 serves as a lasting reminder. Pilots and mechanics study this incident during training. On December 29, 1972, just before midnight, the passenger flight crashed in the Florida Everglades after the flight crew became distracted by a faulty landing gear indicator light. While troubleshooting the faulty light, the captain accidentally disengaged the autopilot by bumping the yoke. Unaware of the change, the pilots failed to notice the aircraft gradually losing altitude. which led to the crash. There were 101 fatalities and 75 survivors. While the faulty light wasn't the direct cause of the crash, it triggered a chain of events that ultimately led to disaster. Aircraft lights are available for sale from aviation suppliers, and proper installation and maintenance ensures they function optimally. Regular inspections, cleaning, and replacements of LEDs or bulbs help maintain visibility and compliance with regulations. At Epic, our maintenance department only purchases brand new lights and parts for our aircraft, valuing safety first. Aircraft lighting is more than just visibility. It's essential for safety, communication, and regulatory compliance. From commercial jets to military fighters, every light serves a purpose: guiding lights, alerting crews, and ensuring smooth operations. Whether it's a pilot using the right lights at the right time, or a mechanic ensuring they function flawlessly, these systems keep aviation running safely day and night. So next time you see an aircraft's lights flashing in the sky, remember, they're more than just a glow. They're a lifeline. For more aviation insights and expert tips, subscribe to Epic Flight Academy to stay informed.